John chapter 1 verse 12 says, "But as many as received him, to them he gave power to become the sons of God, even as many as believe on his name." Good morning, and you are welcome to I Prevail with Joseph Adenuga, the daily broadcast that God sent your way every day to bring strength, comfort, encouragement and motivation to your life. I'm here this morning to inspire you and to send the word of God that brings healing to your spirit, soul and body. Today I pray that God will bless you as you hear the word. The word will do you good and make a way for you where there seems to be no way. Whatever is standing before you as an obstacle is turned to miracle right now. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. Today I want to speak on the topic, the God inside you. When we give our lives to Jesus as our Lord and Savior, God begins to dwell on the inside of us. We become the temple of God. So many places in the Bible says we are the temple of God. The Holy Spirit lives on the inside of us. When you give your life to Jesus, you are no longer ordinary. You have become, the house of God. You see, the day our Lord Jesus Christ died on the cross of Calvary, immediately he gave up the ghost and died and said, "It is finished." The Bible says in the temple, that the curtain of the temple tear from top to bottom. You see, meaning that somebody tear it from the top. You know, if you want to tear something, you tear it from the bottom, because the temple, the curtain is very thick. And the curtain is, very big. But the Bible says it rent from top to bottom, meaning that God have left the Holy of Holies made with hands. God begins to dwell on the inside of a man or a woman that gives his or her life to our Lord Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. So right now, what I'm about to speak to you, I want you to listen and listen good. If you have not given your life to Jesus, and you are listening to the sound of my voice on a daily basis, it is time for you to give your life to Jesus, because you are missing out big on so many goodies that God have in store for you if you have not given your life to Jesus. Going to church is not equal to the fact that you are a child of God. So many people go to church, but they are not born again. They have not given their lives to Jesus. They are not, the temple of the Holy Spirit. God have not started dwelling on the inside of them. But right now, if you have given your life to Jesus, I want to congratulate you. And now, if you want to give your life to Jesus, there is no better time to give your life to Jesus than now. So bow your head, give your life to Jesus, repent of your sins. Say, "Father, I know I'm a sinner. I receive and accept Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. Lord, enter into my life. I believe that Jesus Christ died for my sins, and I believe that he rose again from the dead for my justification. Thank you, Lord, for saving me, for forgiving me all my sins, and giving me a brand new life. I am a new creation. In Jesus' name, amen." If you pray that prayer and you believe in your heart that Jesus Christ came to this world in the flesh, and that he died for your sins and rose again for your justification, and if you can confess it with your mouth according to Romans chapter 10 verse 9 and 10, then you are already a born again Christian. You are saved. And the Bible says that when you get saved, then the life of God is imparted unto you by the Spirit of God. So because you are saved now, God has given you a new life, the life of God. Now, as many of us as has given our life to Jesus and we have received the new life, God is dwelling in us. That is the point of my discussion this morning. God is now dwelling in you. And God says to Moses in the book of Exodus chapter 3 verse 15, he said, "Say to the children of Israel, I am that I am, have sent you." So I am is inside of you. So from today, whatsoever you say, I remember that I am is inside you. So whatever you say using I am, whatever you say after you say I am is going to happen in your life. Therefore, from today, I want you to begin to speak positive words concerning yourself. Don't say, I am broke. When you say, I am broke, you are saying that the I am inside you does not have the capacity to provide for you. And so you weaken yourself. You destroy the alignment between you and the I am that I am. So from today, when you speak, say, I am rich. I am strong. I am intelligent. I am beautiful. I am reliable. I am prosperous. I am wealthy. I am successful. Say good things, because when you say I am, you are aligning yourself with the God inside you, because God is inside you. Never say I am weak, because when you say that, you are destroying the alignment with you and the I am that I am, the God that lives on the inside of you. And that is why so many people are not making progress in their lives. Think about this. Don't say I am broke. Say I am strong. I am rich. I am well. I am intelligent. I am moving forward. I am unstoppable. I am wise. Say good things, because that is what you are. Whatever you say that you are, the I am that I am on the inside of you will make it to come to pass. This way I'm going to stop. Thank you for listening. I believe this blessed you. I'd like you to rebroadcast this. Get somebody blessed. If you love this, somebody rebroadcasted it to you, you want to hear it directly from me, then save my number with I Prevail. My number is +27 74 03 02 381. Thank you so much. I'd like you to be our partner. I do send additional message to our partners every Monday night. Every Monday night, right now, Monday night at night, where I interact with our partners, minister to them, give them some prayers and additional word of encouragement. And if you want this, then consider being our partner. Ask me to send our bank account details to you. Now, whatever you want to use to contribute, then just put that, and we're going to be meeting in Partners Forum. That is a deeper teaching of the Word of God. Thank you so much. It is well with your soul. Once again, I'm Joseph Adenuga, the pastor of Prevailing Church, signing out this morning and saying to you, be blessed and remain blessed.